Welcome back to stage 3 at this advanced demo series. And at this point in the demo series, this is the infrastructure that you have within your AWS account. The two environments, the simulated on-premises on the left and the AWS environment on the right. And in the previous stage of this demo series, you created a VPC peer between both of those environments. Now, in this stage of the demo series, you're going to be provisioning all of the infrastructure at the AWS side. So you're going to start by provisioning the database within AWS. So this includes an RDS subnet group and an RDS managed database implementation. So we're going to configure a free tier eligible single AZ implementation of RDS, and that's going to be the end state database for this application migration. So currently the database is stored on the simulated on-premises environment on the CatDB server, and we're going to migrate that data across to the RDS instance. You're also going to be provisioning an EC2 instance which will function as the web application server. So this is going to be a WordPress instance using an EBS boot volume and data volume. And you're going to install WordPress on this instance and then migrate all of the non-database assets from the current web server across to this brand new EC2 instance. And you'll be using SSH to sync these non-database assets between CatWeb and this new EC2 instance. And at the end of this stage of the demo series, this EC2 instance will be able to communicate with the CatDB database server, and you'll have migrated at least the web part of this architecture from the simulated on-premises environment through to AWS. And at this point, users can connect to this EC2 instance and see the same application. Now, to perform all of these tasks, we need to be at the AWS console, so let's switch over and get started. Now, this is going to be a fairly command-heavy stage of the demo series, so please go ahead and open the text instructions for this stage of the demo series, which are attached to this lesson. The first thing we need to do is to create the RDS subnet group. So let's click on services and then move to the RDS console. Provisioning the RDS instance is going to be the most time-intensive part of this entire demo series, so we're going to get this out of the way first. To get started, go ahead and click on subnet groups on the menu on the left, and then create a DB subnet group. Now, the subnet group determines where RDS puts the database instances. So although we might have a full range of subnets in each of the availability zones in a region, we need to give RDS the directive of where to place its instances. So that's what a subnet group accomplishes. So we're going to call the subnet group A4LDBSN group, and we'll put the same for the description. For VPC, click in the drop-down, and we're going to create this within the AWS environment. So select AWS VPC. Scroll down further, and under Add Subnets, first we need to pick the availability zones that we're going to use. So click in that drop-down, and just go ahead and check the box next to US-East-1A and US-East-1B. We're going to use both of these availability zones for this subnet group. Now we're going to be telling RDS to put the database into the private subnets within the AWS environment. Now if we go to the VPC console and click on subnets, you'll see that we have AWS-Private A and AWS-Private B. Now A uses 10.16.32.0/20 and B uses 10.16.96.0/20. So we need to select both of those subnets. So click in the subnets drop-down, check the box next to 10.16.32.0, and then the box next to 10.16.96.0. So that's private A and that's private B. Once you've selected both of those, scroll down and click on Create to create this subnet group. Next, we need to create the database itself. So click on Databases and then click on Create Database. I'll close down these headings just to make it easier to see. Now we could select Easy Create to make this easier, but we're going to select Standard Create because I want you to have the experience of creating as many RDS implementations as possible. We're going to deploy a MariaDB database instance, so select MariaDB. And then scroll down and under templates, I want you to pick free tier because I want to keep this advanced demo as much within the free tier as possible. Now, if this was a production deployment, then you would select production and that would give you the ability to use larger RDS instance sizes as well as using a multi-AZ deployment. Because this is just a demo, we're going to leave it on the free tier. Now, scroll down further still and we need to enter some values under settings. Now, these values are the ones I told you to note down in stage one of this demo series, the ones that we used as parameters of the CloudFormation template. If you didn't note them down, then just click on services and type cloud in the find services box, locate CloudFormation, open that in a new tab, click on the DMS stack which you created at the start of this demo series and select the parameters tab. And all of the options that we'll be using will be contained within these parameters. So back at the RDS console under DB instance identifier, we're going to use A4L WordPress. We're going to use the same for the master username, so A4L WordPress. And then for the master password, if I just go back to CloudFormation, we're going to use the DB password value. So this is just a random password that I created for this demo series. So just copy that into your clipboard and then paste that in for both the master password and the confirm password. Next, scroll down and we don't need to set anything for the DB instance size because that was set using the free tier template that you selected above. Scroll past storage. Scroll past availability and durability, and we need to change values in the connectivity section. We want to deploy this into the AWS VPC, so click in the dropdown and select AWS VPC. Make sure that the A4L DB SN group is selected, so this is the subnet group that you just created. Make sure that it's set to no for public access, and then under existing VPC security groups, click in the dropdown, and I want you to pick the one that says AWS Security Group DB. Now you'll have some text at the start and some random at the end. Just focus on the one that says AWS Security Group DB, select that, and then delete the default by clicking on the cross. Scroll down again and expand additional configuration. Under initial database name, go ahead and enter A4L WordPress. So this tells RDS to create an initial database called WordPress, which is the one that we'll be using DMS to migrate our data into. That's everything we'll need to do, so scroll all the way down to the bottom and then click on Create Database. Now that will take some time to create, anywhere up to 45 minutes, although usually it is in the range of 15 to 20 minutes. While that's creating, we're going to go ahead and provision the EC2 instance, which will function as our AWS web server. So click on Services, and then into this box type EC2 and click to move to the EC2 console. Now at this stage you will be running some commands, so make sure that you have this stage's instructions open, because using those you can just copy and paste as we need to run commands. So to get started, go ahead and launch an instance. Okay, so first under name type AWS Cat Web, that's what we're going to call this EC2 instance. Then scroll down, click Amazon Linux and make sure Amazon Linux 2 AMI HVM SSD volume type is selected. It should say free tier eligible, just make sure that it does. Directly below that, make sure that architecture is set to 64-bit x86. Scroll down. Under instance type, again, make sure this is set to a free tier eligible instance. In my case, the default is T2.micro. I have seen some cases where T3 instances are free tier eligible. In either case, make sure yours is set to a free tier eligible instance type. Scroll down again and under key pair login, click in the key pair name box and select proceed without a key pair, not recommended. Scroll down, next to network settings, click on edit. Change the VPC to AWS VPC. Change the subnet to AWS-PublicA. You can leave auto-assign public IP to enable, which is the default. Under firewall security groups, choose select existing security group. And then in the Common Security Groups drop-down, go ahead and select the one that contains AWS Security Group Web. It will start with DMS and have some random at the end, that's okay. Just make sure you pick AWS Security Group Web. Scroll down further still, we don't need to make any changes to configure storage. Expand Advanced Details and look for IAM Instance Profile. Click that drop-down. Select the one that contains AWS Instance Profile. Again, it should start with DMS and end with some random. That's okay. So select that. That's everything we need to configure, so go ahead and click on Launch Instance. And once you've done that, you can click on View All Instances. And we'll need this instance to be in a running state and have 2 out of 2 checks before we can continue. So go ahead and pause this video and wait for the AWS CatWeb instance to be running and have 2 out of 2 status checks. Okay, so this is the end of part one of this lesson. It was getting a little bit on the long side, and so I wanted to add a break. It's an opportunity just to take a rest or grab a coffee. Part 2 will be continuing immediately from the end of Part 1, so go ahead, complete the video, and when you're ready, join me in Part 2.